Hey people, I'm Mike Brown from LendEDU. Today, we're talking about what the maximum federal student loan amount is. Most college students do use federal student loans to finance the majority of their college education, but it's important to know that you can't borrow an unlimited amount of federal student loans, and there is a maximum federal student loan amount for each student. But first, let's get into why federal student loans are a good and commonly used option when it comes to financing your college degree. Federal student loans are easy to obtain. They don't require a credit check or a cosigner. They don't have strict financial qualifications. They come with very low interest rates, usually between 2 and 5%, and they have a number of protections and benefits like income-driven repayment plans and forgiveness programs. Because of all those reasons I just listed, in addition to the obscenely high cost of college, federal student loans have become immensely popular and make up the bulk of college financing among students. According to LendEDU, there are 44.5 million federal student loan borrowers out there today. And of the $1.7 trillion in outstanding student loan debt, just $138.57 billion is made up of private student loans, with the rest coming from federal student loans. But as mentioned earlier, the Department of Education does have max federal student loan amounts for each college student. The Department of Education sets these max federal student loan amounts based on personal information, like your dependency status and what information you've included on your FAFSA. Then they include other things like your current year in school and other financial aid you've received. Let's first dive into maximum federal student loan amounts for Stafford loans for dependent students, which means you are listed on someone else's tax return as a dependent child or adult. Stafford loans are education loans provided by the federal government for undergraduate, graduate, or professional students. They can either be subsidized or unsubsidized. The former, or subsidized, means that the government will cover interest costs while you're still in school, while the latter, unsubsidized, means that you have to cover interest costs while in school. Subsidized Stafford loans are only available to undergrad students who also demonstrate a financial need. Subsidized loans will cost you less because the government is covering your interest payments while in school, but with unsubsidized loans, there are fewer restrictions when it comes to the max student loan amount. And as I said earlier, Stafford student loan borrowers can either be independent or dependent, and this too is going to have an impact on the max student loan amount for any one borrower. If you are a first-year undergraduate dependent student, your maximum federal student loan amount for Stafford loans is $5,500, with no more than $3,500 as subsidized loans. If you are a second-year undergraduate dependent student, your max federal student loan amount for Stafford loans is $6,500, with no more than $4,500 as subsidized loans. If you are a third or fourth-year undergraduate dependent student, your maximum federal student loan amount for Stafford loans is $7,500, with no more than $5,500 as subsidized loans. Please note that each of these max federal student loan amounts is for a single year. For dependent undergraduate students, the aggregate maximum federal student loan limit is $31,000, with no more than $23,000 as subsidized loans. Now let's get into maximum federal student loan amounts for Stafford loans for independent students. And all that means is that there's no one else out there that is claiming you as a dependent on their tax return. Now, because independent students are probably handling their college financing on their own, in theory, they likely need more help with federal student loans when it comes to financing their college degree. Because of this, the max federal student loan amounts for independent students are larger than those for dependent students. If you are a first-year undergraduate independent student, your max federal student loan amount is $9,500, with no more than $3,500 as subsidized loans. And if you are a second year undergraduate independent student, your max federal student loan amount is $10,500, with no more than $4,500 as subsidized loans. And if you are a third or fourth year undergrad independent student, your max federal student loan amount is $12,500, with no more than $5,500 as subsidized student loans. Independent students also have to deal with aggregate maximum federal student loan limits. For undergrad independent students, they may borrow no more than $57,500 in federal student loans, with no more than $23,000 of that as subsidized loans. It's important to note that all graduate level students are considered independent students, and they too have maximum federal student loan amounts,
Let's take a look at those.
Any graduate or professional student is limited to $20,500 in federal student loans each year, all unsubsidized. In total, the aggregate maximum federal student loan limit for any professional or graduate student is $138,500, with no more than $65,500 as subsidized student loans. And it's important to note that these max federal student loan limits also incorporate any undergraduate student loans that any of these professional or graduate students took on.
With max federal student loan amounts for Stafford loans now covered, let's take some time going over maximum federal student loan amounts for both PLUS and GRAD PLUS federal student loans.
If a grad student is unable to cover their full cost of college attendance with just federal Stafford loans, they may qualify for GRAD PLUS loans. In that same vein, parents of undergrad students may qualify for Parent PLUS loans if federal Stafford loans are unable to cover the full cost of undergraduate college. The max federal student loan amounts for both Grad PLUS and Parent PLUS loans differ than those from federal Stafford loans in that there actually is no set dollar amount as the annual limit. The only rule is that grad students and parents may not borrow more than the total cost of attendance less any other financial aid received. All right. So what variables impact the maximum amount of federal student loans that any one student is able to qualify for?
There's a few things. Max federal student loan amounts are put in place to curb overborrowing by any one student. And because of this, your max federal student loan amount will be impacted according to other sources of financial aid you've received, like scholarships, grants, and private student loans. Then there are other factors, like your dependency status, your year in school, your enrollment status, like are you full-time or are you part-time? And all of these things are going to impact the maximum amount of federal student loans you can receive, whether that be through subsidized or unsubsidized loans.
In review, federal student loans, they're a pretty good option, right? They're relatively easy to secure. They don't have strict financial requirements. They're pretty cheap when it comes to interest. And they have a number of protections and benefits like income-driven repayment plans and possible student loan forgiveness. And all these things simply can't be matched in the private market. And it makes federal student loans a very, very solid option when it comes to financing your college degree. However, it's nearly impossible these days to cover the full cost of college with just federal student loans. Because of this, it's so important for you to understand what your maximum federal student loan amounts are so that you can put together your college financing plan accordingly and tap into additional resources like Parent PLUS loans or private student loans if need be. Thanks for watching, and if you have any other questions about max federal student loan amounts, please just drop a comment and I'll get back to you. And if you want to find more resources about student loans, check out some of the links I left in the description. And finally, please subscribe to the LendEDU YouTube channel if you want to stay up to date on all of our personal finance videos. I'm Mike Brown from LendEDU. Peace.